I'm here with Dr. Mahadevan, who is an ER physician at Stanford. And what are we looking at here?
Well, what we're going to do is look at some radiographs of the cervical spine or of your neck and try to determine whether they're adequate or not.
What does it mean to be adequate?
When you have an adequate view, you can see from the first vertebra all the way down to the junction of the seventh cervical vertebra and the first thoracic vertebra.
I see. And we call it adequate because it means it's adequate to make a diagnosis.
Exactly. You want to be able to see the entire cervical spine so you can make sure that there's not an injury there.
Cool. And so what are we looking at over here? What are we directly staring at?
So what we're looking at is the lateral, which shows essentially part of the cervical spine. It shows cervical vertebra 1 through 5.
I see. So this is, just to make myself clear, these are both lateral x-rays. When we say lateral, it was the x-ray from the side.
Exactly.
Of the person. And this shows how well I know my anatomy. This person on this x-ray, they're facing this way?
They're actually facing the other
way. See, look at that. Oh, I can see there's a little jaw. Okay. No, I was just testing you. Good job. All right. So the person is facing that way. This way is the front. And you were kind of counting the different the different bones.
Exactly.
There. And you're saying this is 1.
That's 1.
2.
2.
3.
Uh-huh.
4.
Uh-huh.
5. And that's why you hear people sometimes with back injury saying, yeah, I have a problem in what do they call it in like this?
L5. L5,
L5, right. That's,
yeah,
that's what
exactly.
They're talking about like
exactly.
That. Okay, so sorry.
And actually, we count even further forward from there, and we look exactly at those things that look like squares. Those are the actual vertebra, exactly, right there.
This.
Exactly. And although we're interested in the entire spine, when we count, we kind of go down. And as you can see, if you look at the fifth square there.
Right.
Below that, it's really hard to see the squares of 6 and 7.
Right, we can't see anything below that, and it looks like this person's shoulder is blocking it.
Exactly, you can see that big white thing there is the shoulder that's gotten in the way, and it's making it hard to see.
They shouldn't have worn those lead shoulder pads. No, sorry.
and it's making it hard to see whether there's something going on down there right now, so it's really a mystery, as you've shown.
So how do you solve it? How do you solve this problem?
If you look over at the other film, it's what we call a swimmer's view. And what we've asked the patient to do is raise one arm up and lower the other. And in doing so, you kind of clear that lower cervical spine and allow better visualization of the entire spine.
I see. And you're taking it from the direction of the raised arm.
You take it from the side, and you can see.
This is the raised arm right over here.
Exactly. That's the raised arm. Exactly.
And it gets the shoulder. And the other arm on the further side of the patient is down. And that's what allows us to get the shoulder in a position so it doesn't block like it does in this left.
Exactly.
I see. And over here, it is much clearer that this person is also facing in this direction. Okay, so let me see so we can count. This is number 1 right up here.
That's 1.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And yeah, look, we already got to 6. We didn't see 6 over here. And then we got 7.
Exactly.
Okay. And so you would call this an adequate view for what we're trying of the neck, because now we can look at all the way through 7.
Absolutely. We can get all the way down to 7. And ideally, you want to see the top of 1, which comes actually in this counting system. We go 1 through 7. And then we start back at 1 again, because we're starting with the thoracic vertebra. So number 1.
Oh, look at that. It's like one of those streets where they restart numbering. You can't find out. All right. So it becomes 1 again.
Exactly.
And did I number that right?
You did, and again, we're looking more to the front. You've got your numbers perfectly on every spinous process. The little bump that you can feel if you press on the back of your neck.
Right.
But what we're really interested in is the alignment of the front of the vertebral bodies.
Okay, so this is 1, this is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You want to look at the top of 1. Where's the top of 1?
If you just continue down right there, and it's difficult to see, but exactly, you want to see that there's an alignment right in front of the
I'll
vertebra right there.
There's something here that I can't really see.
Exactly.
But you're an expert, so maybe you see things I don't. All right. So now what do we do with this?
Now, we've shown you that you can get a swimmer's view, and it can show you all the way down to C7, T1. But on the original view, as you've shown, we can't see that. So what we did for this patient was get a swimmer's view.
I see. And so this is adequate. And we have this other slide right over here. We have this other one right over here. And why is this one interesting?
This is the same patient, and now we've taken that same view that we talked about before, the swimmer's view, where you've
this
got...
is the same patient as this patient right over here, not this patient over here on the right.
That one
looked overall pretty healthy.
That was a normal swimmer's view, but here is an abnormal swimmer's view,
so
and again,
the same person as this one, not the other swimmer,
facing
view.
In the same direction. In case you want to test it again.
Yes. Okay. Good.
And if you count again, starting with the first vertebra,
one,
so we go one,
two. This is three right here.
Three's this one right here.
Three. Oh, it's a kind of a. Oh, I see. It's a kind of a. This whole thing is three.
That whole thing is three right there.
Three,
exactly.
Four, five, six, and then seven. It looks like right around there. If I'm reading that, if I see that
absolutely.
Properly, it's a little darker
absolutely.
There.
And the key important finding there is that as you draw a line along the anterior or the front of all those vertebral bodies, if you were to connect them,
right,
let me just see like
if I
that.
Can, if I can, I'll draw a dotted line. Okay.
Fantastic.
So looks pretty. All right.
And as you go down.
Oh, look at that. Seven looks like a little disruption there.
Exactly. And it's pushed back. And the problem is right behind those bones is your spinal cord.
Wow.
And so any kind of injury like this potentially could injure your spinal cord and lead to permanent paralysis or weakness.
See. So this is the main thing. I guess there's two big takeaways, at least from this little short segment that we've said, is that one is you got to make sure that you have the information to make a diagnosis on. So for example, this right over here, you couldn't even do something useful because you're not able to see the number six and number seven.
Exactly. And so we would call it inadequate, and we would say we can't draw any firm conclusions from that.
And that's
X-ray.
Why you want them to get in that swimmer's position, raise the arm from the direction that you're looking at.
Correct.
And they'll lower the other arm. And then you can see something like this, and this right over here is cause for trouble, because now you can go all the way down to seven, and you can actually see that they're not aligned.
Absolutely. And so this is someone you wouldn't let get out of your emergency department without seeing a specialist, a spine specialist, whereas if you didn't have that view, you might be falsely reassured that everything was okay, when in fact, there's a serious problem there.
Wow. Very cool. Well, thanks a bunch.
Thank you.